What is primary memory? What is primary memory? So primary memory we can also call it as temporary memory or semiconductor memory or main memory. Okay, so let us talk. What is primary memory? Data stored in temporary basis, that kind of memory is called as primary memory, or this memory we can also call it as semiconductor memory. So the classification is RAM. RAM stands for random access memory. Okay, and this memory is very fast. Okay, so for example, whenever you switch on a computer, first data stored into ROM is going to be activated, then power self test is going on. After that, data is stored into RAM. Okay, for example, you are sleeping, someone is calling to you. Okay, then you have to be activated. Then if someone is saying something to you, then you are going to listening the data, right? So the listening process taken by this RAM. Okay, and we are going to say that RAM is called volatile memory. What is the meaning of volatile? So that means whenever you power on computer, or whenever power is available in the computer, then the data will be stored into some kind of semiconductor, or the data stored in IC is called as volatile memory. For example, someone is talking to you. Okay, so whenever the person is talking with you, then you are reading the data by brain, right? So that kind of memory comes under RAM. Okay, so without RAM, CPU is unable to load the data, right? Without brain, the person is unable to do the works. Okay, so that means CPU is going to be hold instructions or data in order to be processed by user or some application, right? If it is needed, then data is stored into the secondary storage device. Otherwise, data is going to be vanished from the memory. Okay, so simply we can say that data is stored in temporary basis, right? Okay, so basically nowadays the RAM sizes are like 512 MB or 1 GB, 2 GB, 4 GB, 8 GB, 16 GB, 32 GB, like that. If more RAM is available, then the computer stores more application. For example, you are going to load a game in computer. If RAM is big, your game is also consume lot of memory, then your processing is getting very faster. Okay, so most of the computers like 16 bit and 32 GB volatile memory. And RAM classified into two types, like SRAM, DRAM. SRAM means what? Static RAM. Okay, static RAM means it require the first memory is called it as volatile memory. So what is the meaning of volatile? The volatile meaning is temporary memory. So what is the meaning of temporary? Whenever power is on, then data is available. Whenever power is off, data is not available. So technically we can say that it is semiconductor or integrated chip data. Okay, so that means if someone is asking question to you, or if some person is saying some story to you, your brain is listening the data, right? So that kind of process, you won't remember each and every point, just you are listening first. So that process is taken by your brain. Similarly, whatever data you are giving to the computer, so the data first taken by RAM. Okay, so this data taken by CPU, okay, it holding the instruction or holding the data, holding the instruction or holding the data, after that it is going to be processed. Okay, for example, someone is asking a question, where is the address of so and so, then your brain is thinking and your brain is processing. After that you are saying that information to the opposite person, right? So similarly, CPU take the instruction, take the data, then process. After that, if it is needed, then data is stored into the non-volatile. Okay, non-volatile, otherwise the data will be vanished from the memory. Okay, so computer holding the instructions or data, later it will be processed. Okay, so RAM is very important device. Okay, without RAM, no computer. First of all, without primary memory, there is no computer. Okay, so in order to process the data, in order to store the data, in order to maintain the data, okay, first of all, RAM is needed, right? Nowadays, the RAM sizes are like 2 GB, 4 GB, 8 GB, 16 GB. So the memory representation I already given earlier, please watch those videos. Okay, but most of the computers are having 8 GB and 16 GB. If more RAM is available, then your computer is very fast. And very important point is, this volatile memory is very fast. Okay, because it is not storing, right? Very fast. Whenever you store the data, it may be a little bit of slow. Okay, so RAM classified into two types. RAM classified into two types. The first one is comes under SRAM, and the second one is comes under DRAM. What is SRAM? SRAM stands for static RAM, static random access memory. Okay, so it does not require refreshing rate. Okay, it does not require refreshing rate. So that means the content is available until turn off the computer, right? Until turn off the computer. For example, you are doing some work, the work is stored in your computer until power off, and it is very faster, basically SRAM. Okay, and the other one is called DRAM. DRAM requires refreshing rate is needed. Okay, so the data is losing every time because it is refreshing every time to clean the memory. Okay, so it is efficient comparing to DRAM, but SRAM is faster. Okay, so DRAM, nowadays most of the computers having DRAM 1, like DRAM 2, DDR1, DDR2, DDR3 and DDR4, like that. We are using number of RAMs like this for most efficient uses, and it consuming the less power also. In olden days, SRAMs are used, static RAMs, and this one is dynamic RAMs. So the next memory is called cache memory. What is cache memory? Cache memory is nothing but intermediate memory. So this intermediate memory is between RAM as well as CPU. Okay, so that means, assume that there is a some kind of function is going on in your home. Okay, you are going to hire some kind of intermediate persons, we can say that coordinators. Okay, so these coordinators give the communication between your family members and you. Okay, so you are saying something to these coordinators doing the job to these guests. If guest is want to asking something to you because you are busy with the function, okay, so the coordinator fulfill the requirements. Okay, so because of this coordinators, your job is very easy, but you are going to be hire it, costly process. Similarly, whenever you take a computer, whenever the cache memory is high, then your performance is very high. Okay, so first of all, this cache memory load programs or data from CPU to cache. If RAM is asking some job to CPU, first time the CPU is loaded data into cache. Next, this data taken by RAM. Second time RAM is asking the same data, then no need to load from CPU. It is data directly taking from the cache. Okay, so this is the major advantage of cache memory. So cache is faster and costlier temporary storage area used to improve the efficiency of the computer. Okay, so that means once data is stored in the cache, it can be further used by the other components like RAM or any other semiconductors, right? Non-volatile memory. So what is the meaning of non-volatile memory? Non-volatile memory means permanent memory. Okay, permanent memory. So what is the meaning of permanent memory? So the meaning is, this is going to be stored in small amount of data in the concept of ROM, and the permanent data stored means large amount of data stored in secondary or auxiliary is comes under non-volatile memory. So what is the meaning of permanent? For example, you are a student, okay, you are listening a class, the professor or the faculty giving information to you. Okay, so professor is giving information to the number of students. So the information is taken by your brain, okay, processed by your brain like RAM. After some time, you are going to be remember some key concepts like highlighted points. So that is comes under Roam, and you are going to write each and everything in detail. That is comes under secondary storage. So what I'm saying to you, the flow of information is comes under RAM. Okay, so very important points and the basic knowledgeable points is comes under Roam. Whatever things you are writing into the book, that is comes under the secondary storage device, right? So let us talk about Roam. The first category comes under Roam. Roam stands for read only memory. Read only memory, and this Roam we can call it as non-volatile memory. What is non-volatile? When power on or when power off, then data is not erasable. That means data is permanent. Okay, so non-volatile means permanent memory. So what is exact meaning? There are set of programs or instructions or data are going to be stored in one kind of integrated circuit is called IC. This IC name we can call it as Roam. So Roam means what? Predefined set of instructions or data which is stored in one kind of IC. Okay, so that is the reason we can call it as Roam is called firmware. Okay, what is the meaning of firmware? The combination of software plus hardware is called as firmware. What is software? Instructions or programs are needed. Hardware means there is a chip is integrated in a motherboard. Okay, so that is the reason Roam is called firmware. Okay, and whenever computer is power on, these preloaded data is going to be loaded into BIOS. Okay, and BIOS from again Roam, and Roam to RAM, then RAM to you'll expected operating system. So this process is every time. Okay, so whenever power on a computer, there are set of instructions are loaded, then based on basic input output systems, BIOS means what? There is some basic configuration is loaded, then the data is taken by the Roam, data is taken to the RAM. This kind of process we can call it as shadowing. Okay, shadowing. So the process of booting information from BIOS to Roam, Roam to RAM. Okay, so this is called shadowing. Okay, see, basically we can take it as born baby contain some kind of characteristics. These characteristics are needed for the whether the baby is properly available or not, properly living or not. Means like crying, like taking milk, different type of face expressions, everything is programmed inside of the womb. Okay, so that is the chip is called as Roam. Okay, later we are giving the training based on that the baby is going to be grown up. Okay, So initially the baby has memory. This memory is needed to grow up the baby. So similarly, computer is needed some kind of non-volatile predefined memory that is called as a ROM. So ROM is called firmware. ROM is also called as BIOS. Okay, so this BIOS are needed to run a computer with basic configuration. Okay, like keyboard settings, display settings, disk driver settings, and various communication settings. Everything is going to be stored in this preloaded memory chip, right? So basically, ROM is going to be classified different categories. ROM classified into three categories. Read-only memory, that means non-volatile memory, classified into three types. The first category we can call it as PROM. PROM stands for programmable ROM. Programmable ROM, programmable read-only memory. Programmable read-only memory. Okay, so what is the meaning of this? There is a IC. This IC contains set of programs or set of instructions. Basically, we can call it as BIOS. Okay, so once data is stored into ROM, this data cannot be deleted. This data cannot be altered. That kind of ROMs comes under PROMs. The best example is remote chips. You can observe that TV remote IC or AC remote IC or home theater IC. So the data is once stored, we cannot change. So that is comes under programmable ROM. And next one is comes under EPROM. EPROM. So EP stands for erasable. Okay, so erasable programmable read-only memory. Okay, so it is also similar to PROM, but we can modify the data. Once data is stored into the ROM, so this data can be modified. Okay, this data can be erasable with the help of ultraviolet rays or ultraviolet light. Okay, so it can be erased by exposing UV light. Okay, so simple thing is the data we can modify. Here data is not modified, here data is modified with the help of UV. You can observe that, example is, you can observe that like speedometers, digital speedometers of bikes or cars. Okay, once the data is completed, we can reprogrammable. Okay, for new bikes. Okay, this is comes under EPROM. Next one comes under EEPROM. EEPROM. Okay, so the full form is electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. Electrical erasable programmable read-only memory. It is also non-volatile memory. Non-volatile means data is permanent. Okay, so in this memory, data can be modified, data can be rewritten, data can be erased with the help of electrical signals. Okay, electrical signals, that means no need to remove the IC. Okay, so So no need to remove the IC from the hardware, and we had to apply the UV light, and there is a lot of process here, but here no need to remove the content from the hardware. Just we are giving some instructions through electrically, then data we can modify. So our latest embedded systems is based on EEPROM. Our RAMs is also like EEPROM. Pen drives is comes under EEPROM. Everything is comes under EEPROM, right?